Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If you are a first time in this channel, please click subscribe and please click also bell icon so that you will be notified if there is a new video in this channel. In this video, I am going to discuss the consumption of the engine per day. So I am referring to the ship engine. So this is main engine consumption per day for ships. So as a marine engineer, especially if you are a ship engineer, you should know how to calculate your consumption of the engine, because you will be reporting every day to the company. So I wonder why nowadays in maritime schools there is no topic being discussed pertaining to marine engineering mathematics. So just to give idea to the first timer and those who are aspiring to become a chief engineer, then this is your chance to learn. So just study my video. So we have here the problem: solve the metric indicated horsepower of an 8-cylinder single-acting 2-stroke cycle diesel propulsion engine with MEP or mean effective pressure. So this is the average pressure of all cylinder of the engine. So the with MEP of 11 kilogram per centimeter squared at 145 rpm, the cylinder is 650 millimeter bore by 1350 millimeter stroke. So this is the length of stroke. If the specific fuel oil consumption is 153 grams per indicated horsepower hour, what is the fuel consumption per day? So as a marine engineer, you should know how to calculate your engine consumption. So I'm going to help also those cadets, those engine ratings and junior engineers, as well as the second engineers, if you are not graduated in if you are a young engineer, so I think you did not encounter this discussion. But during my time, we study a long time about the engine, about the marine engineering mathematics. So this is one example. So you can use this calculation when you are especially when you are already chief engineer, you can use this calculation. So given we have number of cylinder 8, mean effective pressure 11 kilogram per square centimeter, bore or diameter of the cylinder of the engine 650 millimeter, we have stroke, length of stroke 1350 millimeter, and what we have spoke, specific fuel oil consumption 153 grams per horsepower hour, our RPM is 145 revolution per minute, number of stroke 2. So we have here the conversion. In 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. And we have the formula here. Area is equal to pi diameter squared divided by 4. So this is basic. We learn this one from our high school, from college. We learn already this one. So let us proceed with the calculation. So we will substitute. So we will write first our formula. So the formula of indicated horsepower is equal to mean effective pressure multiplied by length of stroke, multiplied by area, multiplied by what we call the number of cylinder, and multiplied by RPM, which is revolution per minute. So in calculating the length times area, so we have to divide by 4. And finally, our denominator here is 4,500 kilogram meter. So this we're asking, where did you take this 4,500? So this is a constant denominator of metric units when you are calculating indicated horsepower. But in the English units, when you are calculated the horsepower, this is going to be 33,000 foot pounds. So 33,000 foot pounds. But this is metric. We are calculating in metric. So our denominator, constant denominator, is 4,500 kilogram meter. So let us proceed now. So we rewrite the mean effective pressure, which is 11, and how much the value of pi. So this is also constant multiplier. So 3.1416. So I believe everybody, especially if you are engineering or marine or engineers, you know the value of pi, which is 3.1416. So this one here. Then you have to square your diameter of the piston of the cylinder, inside the diameter of the cylinder. So since this is 65, so by the way, I forgot here to explain to you. So 650 millimeter. So if you divide that one into 10, that is 65, because this is our conversion. And 1350 millimeter, if you divide that one into 1000, this will be this will give you 1.35 meter. So in here, so we will square your inside diameter of your what we call the cylinder, because we apply the formula. So diameter squared. So the square of 65 is 4225. So this will be the unit is square centimeter, because we square the 65. So now we substitute also the length of stroke. So here, and then so this one, length stroke, and we substitute the RPM. So as you can see, I substitute. So I am substituting our data into our formula. So this one is this one. And we substitute also number of cylinder. So this one is number of cylinder, and we substitute the RPM. So first, even if you directly this one multiplied all this value and divide by 4 and divide by 4,500, this will give you this data. But in here, I calculate this one first. So I rewrite the mean effective pressure here, which is 11. So I calculate this one here. So as you can see, I multiplied this value 3.1416 times 4.225 divided by 4, and this will give you 3.318.315. So now I just rewrite all the remaining data from here and then divide by 4,500. So now let us proceed with the calculation here. So as you can see, I multiplied all these data. So it is highlighted. As you can see. And this is the result, 571.6129.19. Then I bring down here the denominator, as you can see. And then we will finally calculate the indicator horsepower. So as you can see, I divide this one, this data, and then this will give you 12,702.5 horsepower. So that is how to calculate your indicated horsepower using this all data and this conversion and this also the formula of area. So now let us finally proceed here with our consumption. So remember, our spoke or specific fuel consumption is 153 grams per horsepower hour. So as you can see here, this is our spoke specific fuel oil consumption. So I bring down here and then multiply it by our horsepower, which is this one, as you can see. So that one, 12,702.5 multiplied by uh, 24, because we are calculating the our consumption per day. So 24 hours in one day, so divide by 1,000,000. So so later on I will explain to you the relation of units, so how we cancel the unit. So 1,000,000 grams per ton, the conversion. So I forgot to write here, but anyway, you just follow it. So in one ton, anyway, I will write here. So one ton so is equal to 1,000,000 grams. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is 1,000,000. So I will little bit so let us continue. So I write here the conversion. So 1 ton is equal to 1,000,000 grams. So we'll apply here to convert into metric tons. So 153 multiplied by our horsepower and multiplied by 24 divided by 1,000,000 grams per ton. So if I multiply all this data, this will give you, so as you can see here, I multiplied all this data and this will give you 4,36,16.06. And I bring down the denominator here, which is 1,000,000. When I multiply that one, so finally this is your, so I divide this one, this data, over 1 million. So this will give you 46.64 metric tons per day. So this is your consumption in metric tons per day as per our problem. Now we will trace all the units, how we cancel these units. So in here, this is kilogram per centimeter squared. So how we cancel the kilogram? So here we have kilogram here, which is denominator, so we can cancel the kilogram. And here we have centimeter squared. And here we have also centimeter squared as denominator, so we can cancel the centimeter squared. And here we have meter as numerator, so here also we have meter as denominator, so we can cancel all those units. So the remaining now our result units is horsepower. So next, in here also, so as you can see here, we have units grams. So we have also this is denominator, and we have here grams also, so we can cancel. And here we have horsepower. And here we have also horsepower as denominator, so we can cancel. And here we have hours, so 24 hours per day. So in one day, it's 24 hours. And we can cancel also hour here. So what is the remaining unit? So we have here ton, and we have here day. So our unit is metric tons per day. So this is how to solve the fuel oil consumption with regards with this problem we have here. And if you are a marine engineer and aspiring to become a marine engineer, especially to become a chief engineer, please study my video, because nowadays this topic is not yet anymore discussed in school. So I wonder why, because I am teaching almost 3 years in school, in college, and I didn't see any mathematics regarding to engine. So not the same during my time, we study a lot engine room. We study a lot mathematics for marine engineering. So this is very important, because when you are in the ship, whether you like it or not, you have a lot of calculation regarding engine. So especially for doing the reporting. So I hope you learned something in this discussion. Thank you for watching. So if you like if you found this discussion helpful, please give thumbs up, click like and share, please click subscribe and bell icon. And thank you for watching, and see you on my next video discussion.